A suit filed on behalf of the leader of the indigenous people of Biafra, Nnamdi Kanu, against the federal government concerning his infringement of human rights has been adjourned to 10th December 2021. Hi, welcome to What's Happening. These are the top 10 stories. At number 10, Speaker Plateau State House of Assembly, Abok Ayuba, has denied social media reports that he has resigned from being Speaker of Plateau House of Assembly. Ayuba disclosed this in a statement through his chief press secretary, Atang Bulus Azi. Ayuba further accused the group behind forging his purported resignation of being the same characters that previously fabricated that 16 members staged the purported impeachment from being speaker. At number 9, a federal high court in Abuja on Friday dismissed a suit filed against the Attorney General of the Federation and Minister of Justice, Abubakar Malami, and others challenging the appointment of a consultant to monitor the spending of the $311 million repatriated loot of the former head of state, Sani Abacha. Justice Iyangekwo, in the judgment, held that the suit lacked merit as there was no credible evidence to support the case. At number 8, the senior special assistant, media and publicity, Garba Shehu, while reacting to the removal of Nigeria from the religion blacklist by the Biden-led government of the United States of America, claims Nigeria was included on the list of religious violators after indigenous people of Biafra paid millions of dollars to spread falsehood against President Muhammadu Buhari-led government. He said their aim was to drive a wedge for political advantage between the two religions. At number 7, South African Airways has said it is set to resume its Johannesburg-Lagos route after 18 months of suspending flights to Nigeria. According to the company, it plans to restart the service on December 12, 2021 and will begin with 3 weekly flights to Lagos in Nigeria. Disclosed in the statement, the interim chief executive officer, South African Airways, Thomas Koglo, said the new Johannesburg-Lagos flight would function as a key economic link between the two countries and service the tourism market in both countries. At number 6, President Muhammadu Buhari on Friday met with a delegation of leaders and chiefs from the southeast region of the country, during which they asked for the release of IPOB leader Nnamdi Kanu. He received the delegation compromising of traditional and religious leaders of the Igbo tribe at the State House in Abuja. Details of the meeting between the Igbo leaders and President Buhari were contained in a statement released by the Special Advisor, Media and Publicity, Femi Adesina. At number 5, Minister of Police Affairs, Mohammed Dinyadi, has announced the reintroduction of the Police Public Complaints Committee. He made this known during a sensitization campaign in Lagos. Dinyadi explained that the initiative was in furtherance of President Muhammadu Buhari's quest for people-centric security, which prioritizes respect for citizens' rights and addresses genuine infractions. He further said that the reintroduction is to boost confidence and deepen cooperation between the police and Nigerians, amongst others. At number 4, the Nigerian Army disclosed that they repelled an attack by the Islamic State of the West African province in Damboa, local government area, Borno State, on Friday. The acting general officer commanding 7th Division of the Nigerian Army, Brigadier General Abdul Wahab Eyitayo, said that a number of the terrorists on 10 gun trucks and one Phantom NRAP attempted to attack Damboa super camp of the Nigerian Army, adding that as they approached, the troops swiftly repelled the attack and forced terrorists to withdraw in disarray through the Sandia village. Abdul Wahab said total normalcy has been restored in the town. At number 3, Rio 2016 Paralympic Games gold medalist and world record holder in the men's 65 kilograms powerlifting category, Paul Kehinde, popularly known as Olumi Agberin, has been announced dead after a brief illness. A media attached to Nigeria Paralympic Federation, Fred Edore, confirmed his death on Friday. His death came barely 5 weeks after being issued a 30-month ban for committing an anti-doping rule violation by the International Paralympic Committee. At number 2, Delta State governorship aspirant for the 2023 general election, Chief Kenneth Okpara, passed on Friday 19, 2021. According to reports, Obara, who is a former commissioner for finance and economic planning in the state, died around 3 a.m. on Friday at Capitol Hill Hospital, Warri. It was gathered that Opara had been battling with an illness for the past 3 years and was said to have been rushed to the hospital on Thursday, where doctors confirmed that his condition had deteriorated. At number one, a suit filed on behalf of the leader of the indigenous people of Biafra, Nnamdi Kanu, against the federal government concerning his infringement of human rights has been adjourned to 10th December 2021. During the hearing today at the High Court in Abia State, Justice Benson Aya, who presided over the sitting, issued an order restraining security agencies from deploying their personnel to the court premises each time the case of Kanu is heard there. The court also restrained them from maltreating anybody who attends the court to witness Kanu's proceedings. Always remember to wash your hands, wear your mask, and stay safe. That's all for now. See you next time on What's Happening.